Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to breathe new life into a classic machine, the venerable ThinkPad T420.2 by installing Neptune 8.1, codenamed Juna. Neptune OS is a Debian-based distribution with a beautiful and efficient KDE Plasma desktop, making it a great choice for both productivity and everyday use, even on slightly older hardware like our T420. First, you'll need to download the Neptune 8.1 ISO file from the official Neptune website. Second, you need a USB flash drive, preferably 8GB or larger. Third, you'll need a tool to create a bootable USB drive from the ISO file. Popular choices are Rufus for Windows or Etcher for Windows, Mac OS, and Linux. It is critical that you back up all important data on the T420 before you begin, as we may erase the hard drive during the installation process. Once you have the bootable USB ready, plug it into your ThinkPad T420. Turn on your T420. When the ThinkPad splash screen appears, press F1 repeatedly to access the BIOS setup utility. If you miss it, just reboot and try again. In the BIOS, first press F9 to restore the default settings, then go to the Startup tab and set EFIC Legacy Boot to EFI only, and thirdly press F10 to save the settings and exit. The system will then reboot. When we see the ThinkPad boot screen again, press F12 repeatedly to get to the boot menu where we choose to boot from the USB HDD. After that, we will see Neotune's operating system selection. I chose Neptune Live English to try it out first instead of installing it directly. This is a good way to test if everything is working correctly before confirming the installation. At this point, Neptune loads into the live desktop environment. On this ThinkPad T420, this loading process takes about a minute or so. Now that we're in Neptune's live desktop environment, I've opened System Monitor first to see how the system resources are being used. Assuming all is well, you should find an icon on the desktop installing Neptune. Double-click this icon to start the installation process. The installer is graphical and fairly straightforward. First, you'll be asked to select your language. Select your preferred language and click Next. Next, you'll be asked to select your location, which will help you set your time zone. The keyboard layout screen follows. Choose your keyboard model and layout. You can use the text box provided to test if your keys map correctly. Now we come to the partitioning section. This is a critical step, so pay close attention. If you want to erase your entire hard drive and install Neptune, select the Erase Disk and Install Neptune option. This is the easiest method, but will erase everything on the selected disk. Make sure you have backed up all important data. In User Settings, you'll be asked to set up your user account. Enter your name, the name you want to use for your computer, a username, and choose a strong password. You can also choose to sign in automatically or require a password to sign in. The installer will show you a summary of the changes it will make to the disk. Take a close look at this, and if it looks right, hit Install Now. You'll get a final confirmation prompt, and you'll just have to click Continue to start writing to the disk. This will take a few minutes as Neptune copies files and configures the system. You can keep an eye on the progress bar. On this ThinkPad T420 laptop, the installation took almost 10 minutes. Once the installation is finished, you'll see a message saying it's done. You'll see a message that says, "Restart your computer." Just click Restart Now. Before the T420 reboots, the installer might ask you to remove the USB installation medium. When you see the prompt, just take out the USB drive. Your ThinkPad T420 should restart and boot into your newly installed Neptune 8.1. After booting into Neptune for the first time, I opened System Monitor to see what kind of resource usage ratio we have when the model is active. Next, we clicked on About This System in System Settings to check the software and hardware versions and models. Next, we opened console and ran sudo apt-update to check for updates. run sudo apt-get dist-upgrade to see, download, and install the updates. On this ThinkPad T420 laptop, the updates took almost 5.5 minutes to install. With the video almost done, I'll sum up what it's like to run Neptune 8.1 on a ThinkPad T420. First of all, Neptune 8.1 has great support for older Intel hardware like the ThinkPad T420, so big things like Wi-Fi graphics, sound, and keyboard features tend to work out of the box, or with minimal effort. Second, the Plasma desktop runs smoothly. Opening apps like web browsers, file managers, and document editors feels smooth. It's easy to multitask with a bunch of apps open. It's great for tasks like writing, coding, browsing the web, watching videos, managing files, and general office work. At last, putting the ThinkPad T420 and Neptune 8.1 together really shows off the strengths of each one. The T420 gives you an excellent, durable, and easy-to-use platform, and Neptune 8.1 gives you a modern, stable, and secure operating system with all the software you need for productivity, communication, and multimedia. To sum things up, the ThinkPad T420 running Neptune 8.1 at Juna is more than just a gimmick. It's a great example of solid engineering and the power of open source software. If you've got an old ThinkPad T420 that's just sitting there collecting dust, or you're on the lookout for a cheap but solid Linux laptop, you should definitely think about giving Neptune 8.1 a shot. Thanks so much for tuning in today. If you have any questions about the ThinkPad T420 or Neptune, feel free to leave them below. See you next time.